right? So here, if you look after the points A, B, C, D, this filled with water. So whenever the depth increases, the pressure is increasing. As the pressure increases, the length of water flow is increased. So write down, write down. So just sketch it down. So this is the first character of hydrostatic pressure. The pressure increases with depth. Second character. Right? Second character. Pressure at the specific point is equal. Second character. So this is the diagram for first character. So second character diagram I draw it here. Right? So if you look after, if you take a bottle filled with water, so here, if you put holes the same distance, the same depth, the water speed, right, the length of water speed will be the same. The length of water speed is the same. So here what it demonstrated is same depth. At same depth, the pressure is equal. Here, whenever the depth is high, pressure increasing. Therefore, the flow where the water falls is increased either. Okay, but not here. Fine, just draw it. Right, draw it. The first character. So this is the water level. Whenever the point A is more depth, the depth increases. What happens? The pressure is increased. Whenever the water falls, it spills the most. Spill far away. Right? That's basically what I'm saying. Pressure at a specific point is equal. Okay, pressure at a specific point is equal. Right. So third character. Pressure acts in hydrostatic pressure acts in hydrostatic pressure acts in all direction. In all direction. Let's say that there's a balloon filled with water, right? If you consider a point, let's say at this point the pressure is 5 Pascal. This 5 Pascal will act in all direction. It has no uniform perfect direction. Neither up, down, left, that side, right, left, everywhere it acts. Everywhere it acts, right? It acts in all direction. So that's the point. But if you consider about solid pressure, let's say that you have kept a box on the surface. Here the pressure acts in only one direction. Only for down direction. But if you consider about liquid, whenever you consider about a fluid, the pressure acts in all directions. Whenever there is a surface, it acts only. It acts only. That is what I say. It acts in all directions. It has no perfect direction at all. Yeah, in this one, the water flow, this length will be equal. This length will be equal. No differences. Right? Equals all direction. Fine. No. At any point, at any point, the water pressure, let's say that there's a large lake, let's say that there's a fish. So we calculate what the pressure here. So let's say that here the pressure is 5 Pascal. This 5 Pascal will act in all direction. Okay, it acts in all direction. It has no uniform direction at all. That's the issue. No. It acts in all directions. Understand what I say? There is no uniform direction of flow. Hydrostatic pressure acts in all directions. Wherever there is a surface, it acts. For example, let's say that we did last class, right? We talked about a box. There's a box on something. Whenever we have this box is here the pressure acts out upward. The force was upward. Here the pressure act downward. The force was downward. So here the two pressure, they act in different ways. Wherever the possible surfaces are gained, it acts. There's no uniform place stamp. Okay, it has no uniform direction pad. Right. Fine. Now let's come to the point. Put the head in. Floating and up thrust. This question, what is up thrust? Right. Up thrust is a force act on objects which immersed in a fluid upthrust is a force act on objects which immerse in a fluid upthrust is an upward force that upward force act on objects which immerse in any fluid. Wait. Point on the star. Definition is missing 1 point. Wait. Upthrust is an upward force exerted by fluids on any objects immersed on it. So whenever it is immersed, it can be partially or fully. Partially or fully. Write down that I'll explain. Objects immerse. Partially or fully. Partially or fully. What is upthrust? Upthrust is an upward force exerted by fluids on any objects immersed partially or fully. I'll explain what it is. So sometimes the definition in book might change. Yeah. Immerse means sinking, right? Sink. Immerse means what? Sink, basically. So that's the word that we can give properly. Immerse. Right. Yes, guys, I will explain what basically the idea is. What basically the idea is, right? So let's say that the three vessels with water, and here an object, right? And in the second part, here the object, right? So it is partial inverse. Partial inverse means what? Like the inverse. What level is here? It has been partial. Only the half part of it has been immersed. Right? So this one, partial inverse. Murusa Amitya. Partial inverse. Right? So here, if you observe this object, this is a fluid. So the definition of APRAS says us. Come on, grade 7 people. I think so. Even for my students, this is the first time that I teach it here. Everyone. Come on, everyone. APRAS, the first point, it is an upward force. It always acts upward. That's why we call it upthrust. Upward force. Second condition, when an object is partially or fully immersed. Mean my word when I say. So here what can the word? It is partially immersed. Here, fully immersed. Here, not immersed. Amitra Padalek, it is not immersed. So now guys, whenever partially or fully immersed, the force which is acting upward. So here it acts upward. It acts upward. Right? It acts upward. That specific force we call what? Upthrust. Which exerts the force? The fluid gives the force. Fluid push it upward. Right? So, right, this is made of A, B, C. So what you can say? Upthrust act. Here upthrust is not acting. No upthrust. Here, upthrust acts. Yeah, it is not immersed in water. That's why. Partially. Not half, partially. I didn't say it half. Come on, come on, come on, people. Don't. Yeah, measure is a force. Measure in newton. Come on, easy. Do not underestimate or misunderstand what is a thrust. Yes, it. As there is a thrust, as the ability of a beaver, even if you think of it, right? We did the last question. Can you remember in the final RRC class? We did a question. The RRC class. We calculated even the friction, even the thrust. So up thrust is resulted due to the pressure difference. That you will, if you want, you will calculate and study once we go for your advanced level, right? Here it's not required. Let's say it's not required. But the point, guys. Okay, point, guys. If you understand, boys, let's understand one thing. Here the more important point is, as there is a thrust. The objects float as there is a thrust. Not floating makes up thrust. Up thrust make object float. Up thrust make objects float. Understand what I say? Up thrust is the cause for floating. Not floating is the cause for up thrust. Even if they ask me why up thrust, is the pressure difference. Is the pressure difference. Right? Okay, let it. So now we are talking a bit complex. I'm going a bit another step complex, right? Come on, here's it. Now we know there's up thrust in these two setup. A and B, so B and C, there is up thrust. Which has the most up thrust? B or C, which has the most up thrust? Yeah. Which has the most up thrust? C has the most up thrust. So write down. And write a point. Come on. I'll write a point. Here, come on, Jesse. Of setups, B and C. C has the highest up thrust of B and C. C has the highest. Right? Because the up thrust depends on the volume of object immersed. More important point. Depends on the volume of object immersed. How much centimeter cube the object has immersed. Yeah, I'll explain. C has the highest up thrust because the up thrust depends on the volume of object immersed. If you take this box, if I draw this box properly, it's going to look like this. It's going to be like this. Right. So let's say in setup C, so let's say that here it is 5 centimeter, 1 centimeter, and this height is 2 centimeter. Whenever it is immersed, 2 centimeter. Now they say, right? Let's just draw it. Consider the below box is sinking or immersed. Immersed. Right? immersed. Depth immersed in setup C. So in setup B.
Right, later I'll explain again. Oh yes, I just come to the explanation.
So now what is the volume immersed, guys? What is the volume immersed? This is the volume immersed. This specific volume was immersed in setup B. So what is the volume of it? 5 into 1 into 2 centimeter cube. So it's going to be 10 centimeter cube, right? In here, so you can say that 10 centimeter cube immersed. 10 centimeter cube immersed. So let's say that the total length is 4 centimeter. So here, how much immersed? Here, 5 into 1 into 4. So here it's going to be 20 centimeter cube immersed. 20 centimeter is more immersed than this.
Right?
This setup is more immersed than this. And here's it. Come on, mark my words. If the immersed volume is high, the thrust is high. Here the immersed volume is less. Therefore, here up thrust is high. Up pushing is high here. Okay?
So write down.
As C has immersed 20 centimeter cube, the up thrust is high. The up thrust is high.
Yeah, that's correct. That's definitely correct, Rafa. The up thrust is directly proportional to the volume. That's correct.
Plenty of your mind. And I didn't give that point for you, right? Because calculating is not there for you. Okay.
Right.
Archimedes principle. Right, let it be. Okay, let this setup be, right? And here we are adding some other principles, right, to make it true what basically happening. Okay. Right. Archimedes principle. So Archimedes is basically a scientist, right? Archimedes is basically a scientist. This guy, he is the first person who gave the idea about this up thrust floating. Now, how you can make any object floating, right? Any material to float.
This guy talked about it, right? This guy talked about that, right? Fine.
So when Archimedes sent to us. Right now, when an object partially or fully immersed in a fluid. The upthrust acting on it equals to the weight of displaced water. Displaced water. Displaced water. Right. So, but he wanted to prove this idea. So, what he displaced free, yeah. Should be free, not water. Right. So, he wanted to prove it. So, what he did is he created a vessel, right? We call it the Eureka vessel. What is the name? Eureka vessel. This Eureka vessel look like this. Right? This Eureka vessel look like this. Fine. Right? So he made such a vessel. So in this vessel, what he did is he filled water until here. Okay, he filled water until here. So whenever something is inserted, something is immersed partially or fully, the water level rise up, so the water will fall and it can collect it separately. Okay. So now let's say that you are making two different vessels, Eureka vessels. Preparing two different Eureka vessels, right? So Eureka vessel, the water is like this. You have to collect the displaced water. So now same size objects. Now you are immersing it into it. So if you partially immerse. This amount of water will displace. Only this amount of water will displace. If you fully immerse, this amount of, large amount of water will displace. So what he said is, the upthrust acting, right? is the weight of this, is the weight of this, weight of this displaced what, water or liquid. So let's say here it is partially, half of it is immersed, half of it is immersed, right? Exactly the half is immersed. As half is immersed, guys, as half is immersed, so now what's happening? Half amount of water. So let's say if you consider the same box B and C, the previous diagram, here it's going to be 10 centimeter cube of water displaced. Here it's going to be 20 centimeter cube of water displaced. So here the weight will be double than this. The weight will be double than this. So Archimedes said that when an object partially or fully, if you put partially or you can put fully, immersed in a fluid, any fluid, can be water, can be anything like that, any fluid, the thrust acting on it equals to the weight of this displaced fluid. The weight, this weight equals. Did you get to the point when I say?
Come on, guys. Did you get what I say? Yeah,
if the volume increasing, the thrust increases. If the volume increasing, the thrust increases. I simply, if I ask you, iron never float. If you put a piece of iron, never float. But if you change the shape of it into like this, into a vessel, same iron, the volume is being increased. As the volume is being increased, the displaced volume is high. As the displaced volume is high, it is floating. Do you get the point that I say? Whenever the displaced volume increases, the thrust increases. You can make float any matter, if you change their shape. If you change the shape, as it can be increased up thrust, then you can make it flow. You get my point what I say, guys? Are you clear?
Yeah, this here's it.
How much the water displays, that differ. You full of water, nare kandi varu, konja potu sonna, konja varu podu. Understand what I say?
Right now. Wait,
here's it, guys. I didn't come for the point of weight. No, no, weight is the point of water, right? I'll come there.
I'll explain it simply. Yeah. Archimedes principle is very important. Yeah, should be memorized. Yeah. Correct. 5500 centimeter cube. Your answer is correct.
इतने का बना इसे नहीं लेट्स डू अ क्वेश्चन राइट लेट्स डू अ क्वेश्चन राइट आ द मास ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट The mass of an object is 200 grams. Is 200 grams. Now let's put 800 grams. 800 grams. This question. What is the weight of object? Weight of object. The below practical was done. Using the above object. Right. So now what they do is they attach this object. And let's say this is the object. Right, they attach this object, and what will be the reading of it? What will be the reading of it? Okay, and then what they do is they do same thing, right? Same thing. In this way, same object. But this time it has been immersed. Okay, it has been immersed in the water in Eureka vessel. Right? Partially immersed. And the weight of this here it was 3 newton. Okay? The displaced water is how much? 3 newton. So here the setup B. So the first question, what will be the reading at A? Second question, what will be the reading at B? Right.
Yeah, you should memorize it.
They ask you the reading, no need to require generation. Right now, let's say that, come on, in this case, here, 8 Newton is the weight. If it is 8 Newton the weight, here the reading will be 8 Newton. But once it is immersed down, here is 3 Newton, means the upthrust is 3 Newton. What does it mean? Upthrust is 3 Newton. So 3 Newton, it is pushing upward. 3 Newton pushing upward. So 8 Newton was downward. 3 Newton upward, 8 Newton downward. Here the reading will be how much? 5 Newton. 3 has reduced. Someone is pushing up. So here should be 5 Newton. Here should be 3 Newton.
The resultant. Very good. The resultant. That's the correct word. Very good.
How I found that? This was the object. Right? 8 Newton was downward the weight. Upthrust was 3 Newton upward. So here, 3 here should be how much? 5 Newton. They must be balanced. Right? 5 Newton. That 5 Newton will be the reading there.
Right. Fine.
Yeah, another first question, right? Here I explain something. Yeah, this is same. These two are same, right? Now, where the color is? Right. If you are done, shall I erase it? We have some complicated question to do in this part.
Past paper questions.
Till you never understand, sometimes. The next heading. Floating. Right on. If the weight of an object is higher than the maximum, upthrust can be given by a fluid. The specific object will sink in the fluid. In the fluid. In the fluid.
in the fluid.
In the fluid. Second statement. If the weight of an object, is lesser than the maximum of thrust. Maximum of thrust can be given by fluid. The specific object will float. The specific object will float in the fluid. In the fluid.
Right. Okay, fine guys, I'll explain this point in the next class. That's on Thursday.
Right, Thursday. So guys, an important issue statement that you know, the class will be Tuesday 8 to 9:30 and Thursday 8 to 9:30. Right? 8 to 9:30. You know, I have put an extra hour just to know what I'm going to do. 8:15 to 9:15, right? So here's it. Once we are done with this, we will be starting quantification of elements, right? Quantification of elements, grade 10 and 11 in common, fine? Grade 10 and 11 in common. So, please make sure to attend the sessions, right? So, if you have any issues with the issue, sometimes whenever you register, it will ask for pay now, no need to pay. That pay now will disappear once we approve it, right? We'll approve it, okay? I'll ask the admin to remove it for only for our RCSE. Your class, we are starting also grade 10 and 11 maths 3 classes as well. Maths 3 classes. Their timetable, I'll give you their timetable, right? I'm assuming the timetable.
That's fixed time. No, I can't. We don't have any other time. Just think of
where is the time in the bagan, right? So even start with math 3 classes where it will cover mostly grade 10 difficult parts. Grade 10 difficult parts to grade levels, right? So here see, all the things will happen throughout the LMS using. So there will be something math grade 10 and 11 free classes. Do not just put for the theory classes. I saw some people have requested for theory, that's you need to pay, right? They are not free classes, fine. So make sure you put, you know, I'll change the name and I'll inform you how the course name is, right? How the course name is RRC, rapid revision classes or something like that. I will inform you. Even the maths, you can join for free of charge, and I will share some flyers today. Please share among your friends who you need. Right, mostly we will be covering grade 10 difficult parts of grade 11. Understand what I say? Grade 10 difficult parts of grade 11 and 10 and 11. 10 people can join. 11 people say grade 10 difficult parts. So it's a difficult part, right? So I'll give you a tune, inshallah, for the next class. From next class, I'll give you a tune for this unit, this specific unit. So there you should do it and practice. See, here I'm doing it for free of charge. For outsiders, you know, some people are new for me. Those students here, if you work, if you cooperate with me, you will come up with me, right? So, here I use this let me info. I'll be doing the difficult part. Grade 11 and 10. Whoever wish to join, you can join. I'll share the video as well. Yeah. If come, request to pay. However, they will accept it quickly, right? They'll accept it quickly. They are not remaining it. Please put your name properly, right? We don't know. We put your phone number properly. Now, once you go, I said you go for the my account and put your name, because once we identify, we can approve it, right? Also, better maintain one account. Everyone, maintain one account and register for several courses. What you? Mathematics account, Karakavana. Right? So, I have bought the server for 25,000 accounts, right? 25,000 accounts. Then I advanced our program, I introduced Pandavay. Okay? If 2,800 account open, right? So, please make sure not to open irrelevant. So, if we see, here I'll just show you. Come on, look after this. In this cases, here see. This is how people attended today. Here, if you are the case, remove Pandu, all of the same order. Here, see, there are some people who are not attended. We will remove those people. Pointless of having them, right? 5, 6, 7, 8, and all, we'll remove them. Okay, so please, name and if you request for a paid class, the admin will contact you for the payment, right? There are free and paid classes, fine? Okay, that's it. We'll end the session for today. No, better open two different accounts for you and your brother. No issues, right? No need to keep one. One person, one account. Once you open more, it's difficult for us. We feel tired. We confused sometimes, right? So I'll share a flyer. Please share my contact. We'll be starting for the maths as well. So this is a COVID relief package from us, right? Okay, bye. Assalamu alaikum.